Welcome back to my channel. So today I have a tutorial for you and it is inspired by the new Mary Kay mini eye palettes coming out for fall and winter. There are two versions of this palette. There is one that has more pink and purple jewel tones, and then there's one with more warmer brown and emerald tones. So I am using that one and it is Emerald Noir. It is this palette right here. The colors in this are gorgeous and they are of such good quality. So I just thought, why not throw together a look for you? So if you want to find out how I got this look, then of course just keep on watching. Okay, so to start off, I'm going to be using my L'Oreal Voluminous Smoldering Eyeliner, and I'm just going to be placing this all over the lid up into the crease, but not going past my crease. You can do this kind of messy, don't worry about being too neat, because we're going to go back in with a flat shader brush and just smooth out the edges. This is going to act as a base to make sure that emerald color really pops. This little mini eye palette does come with 5 different shades, and I'm going to be taking the lightest brown in this palette and I'm going to be putting this in my crease with my eye blender to act as my transition color. I am telling you and warning you now that these shadows are ultra soft and buttery and just so blendable, so you have to really be careful. A little goes a long way. Then taking the darker brown on my Real Techniques Essential Crease Brush, which is just kind of like a smaller version of my eye blender, and the bristles are a lot more stiff, and I'm going to be putting this just right along the edge of where that black liner ends. This is going to help smooth out the color and help everything blend in more nicely, so it's not so much of a harsh green and then to our really, really soft transition color. It's going to just all melt in really nice together, and it's going to give more depth to the eye. So I am focusing this more on the outer corner of the crease and just pushing it inward. Now for the fun part. So I'm going to take this beautiful, beautiful emerald green on my new favorite brush. This is from Morphe, and if you guys haven't checked them out, their brushes are really, really good quality and they're really affordable. This is the B27, and I'm just going to be pushing this all onto the area where we had that black liner and just hitting it very lightly up into the crease. What makes this brush so great is that it has this tapered edge of it, which really helps with blending as well as applying color. Then just going back in with that essential crease brush one more time and just really smoothing out those edges where the lighter color meets with the green. Now to just clean things up a bit, I am taking my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer and I'm just running this all underneath my eye and up along the edge where I'm going to get a really nice clean cut. This is in the shade NW15, and then I'm going to just go back in and drag it all down to give my eye a little bit of a lift. Then with whatever excess product I had, I'm using that and my little beauty sponge from Real Techniques to highlight the rest of my face. I did dampen the sponge, and I'm just going to be pressing this into my foundation, which I had already applied. Everything that I had prior done to this as far as my foundation and eyebrows will be listed down below. Then just taking my pale yellow setting powder from my Bobbi Brown concealer kit. I'm just going to be setting that under eye area as long as the other areas of the face where I did apply that concealer. Then taking my Bobbi Brown Longwear Eye Pencil in the shade Jet, and I'm going to be tight lining those upper lashes as well as my bottom lashes. So since I do want this look to be pretty smoky and dramatic, I am going to be pushing that liner just underneath that bottom lash line where I'm going to just go in back with some eyeshadow and blend it and smudge it all out. So just taking this really teeny tiny pencil brush from Morphe once again, I'm going to be picking out some of that darker brown color from the little palette and just running that and pressing it into the area where we have put that black eyeliner. And then I'm just going to be dragging it back and forth to really just soften it up and smooth it and blend it out. This really helps create that nice, sultry, soft, smoky eye. And then taking a smudge brush with that lighter color, or that lighter brown, and run that just along the bottom. This is just gonna help bring warmth back into that bottom liner so it's not so harsh and dark. It's just gonna help soften the look up a little bit. But again, this all helps out with the whole smokiness of it. Now to highlight our inner corner. I'm taking a flat shader brush and I'm just going to be picking up that center color. It's this beautiful, beautiful champagne gold, and just putting that on the tear duct. And of course, it is not a finished eye, for me at least, until I add my wing liner. So I am applying my Bobbi Brown Longwear gel liner in the shade Black Ink, and just, applying it like normal. And you guys, I gotta say, I'm super proud of myself because I actually did this without having to kind of tug at my eyelid like I normally do, and with one hand. So, snaps for me. Sorry if I'm being ridiculous. Then taking my Bobbi Brown Extreme Party Mascara, and I'm applying a few coats onto my top and bottom lashes before going in with some falsies. But before any falsies, I am taking a little bit of my Mary Luminizer and just applying that right onto my brow bone. And boom, lashes are done. These are from Ardell. These are the Glamour line. These are the 102 Demis in black. Now moving on to the rest of my face, I am just going to be contouring like normal, for starting off with my nose. And I am using my Bobbi Brown bronzer in the shade Golden Light, and also going back in and contouring the frame of my face. Then to set the other areas of my face where I had highlighted, I'm actually going to be going back and putting some of my Skin Weightless Foundation from Bobbi Brown. This is considered a foundation, so I did want just a little bit more coverage. This whole foundation and makeup look I have right now is a very, very full coverage look, and I'm just taking that on the brush so it kind of just loosens it up a little bit and it's not super full coverage, but I'm just going to be using this as setting powder since it is really good at controlling oil. Then for blush, I am taking my Bobbi Brown Coral Shimmer Blush. I just think that this is just a beautiful color for any makeup look, well, at least most. And another great blush that would go with this is a very, very nice deep plum or cranberry. So if you are a darker skin tone, and even if you're light, I mean, you do you. But yeah, on olive skin tones or darker, I mean cranberry, and then this eye is just going to be totally screaming fall. Absolutely beautiful too. And then taking another favorite new brush of mine. This is also from Morphe. This is the B1. It is huge and absolutely love it. I think I mentioned this in my last video. But I'm just going to be taking this and some of my Mary Kay bronzing powder. This is not the kind of bronzer or the same kind of bronzer I use to contour. This has a little bit of shimmer. This is going to add a nice bronze tint to my whole face. So that's why I'm using this big, big brush, because I didn't want to be so pale. So yeah, and then just pushing this all onto my neck and my décolleté just to add a little bit of color and shimmer. And then going in with my Mary Luminizer once again and my Bobbi Brown Sheer Powder Brush, and I'm going to be taking this onto the high points of my cheek, center of my chin, bridge of my nose, and of course my Cupid's bow before applying any lip color. And then yeah, pretty much this look is done. All right, so for this look, I did want to give you guys two options or two ways you could wear this. This is a more pink nude look for something a little bit more subtle, and you can keep all the drama focused on the eyes. Now, lip number two is going to be this nice plum, perfect for fall, and of course, adds a little bit more drama. Both of these are both mixtures of a lipstick and gloss from NYX Cosmetics. I will list them down below. But that's it for this tutorial. Hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. Bye!